Chetan means consciousness. Two things we find generally, conscious and unconscious. It's like this table is unconscious, but a small ant, it is conscious. Ant is coming this side, you try to stop it, it will struggle, it will resist, because it is conscious. But the table, you take it and throw it away, it will not protest, because it is unconscious. This consciousness is the symptom of life, and that develops one after another. Just like within the earth, you have seen, you go to the beach, you'll find within the sand, there are so many living entities. But they are inferior. And the plants on the sand, we have seen, there are many green plants, herbs, they are better. They have improved their consciousness. But better than these plants and herbs are the crawling insects, snakes, snail, because they can move. The herbs, they cannot move. And within the sand there are living entities, they cannot sprout. So in this way, this is called evolution, one after another. So the insects, the reptiles, they are better than the standing herbs and plants. And these insects, the worms, they grow wings at the end of their life. In this way, they are elevated to the bird's life. In this life, they could not attain the bird's life, but on account of very strong willingness, they grow the wings, and next life they become small birds, they fly. So they are better, the small birds, they are better than these insects. Then there are birds, big, big birds, the eagle birds, they can fly very high. In this way, beast life, that is better. In this beast life, then human life and civilized life, that is better. And then civilized life, that is better. Then civilized life, those who are organized, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they are better. And amongst the Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, the Brahman is the best. Because they are on the platform of spiritual realization. This is the evolution. Evolution, we are coming in that evolution. Bahu-sambhavante, bahu-sambhavante, bahu-nam-janmanavante, bahu-sambhavante. So this human life is after many, many evolutionary process. We have forgotten that. So this life is meant for jnanam, ultimate knowledge. In the lower grade of life, there is jnanam, there is consciousness, there is knowledge. Mosquito knows where to bite. The knowledge is there. They will bite on the joints. That point there is mosquito, you have to eat your hands and eat the joints. But they know where to bite. This knowledge is there. For eating, sleeping, and sex life, nobody takes education for sex life. Nobody takes education for eating or sleeping. Where is the education? That you shall eat like this, you shall sleep like this, you shall have sexual intercourse like this. That is automatically known. This knowledge is automatically known. So human civilization does not mean that scientifically, you have to do this, do that, eating, sleeping, mating. That is going on, scientifically. Now the science of mating is that we shall have sex intercourse, but there will be no pregnancy. Contraceptive. So this is not knowledge. Knowledge is different thing. Knowledge means jnanam nisrasarthaya purusasya atmadarsanam. That is knowledge. Atmadarsanam, self-realization. That is jnanam. Otherwise, this lower jnana, knowledge, how to eat, how to sleep, how to perform sexual life, and how to defend, this knowledge is there even in the mosquito or small ant. And what to speak of other higher grade living entities. That is jnanam. But that is not nisreshaya. Shreya and praya, there are two things. Praya means to fulfill immediate necessities of life. That is called praya. And shreya means the knowledge. Shreya means the goal of life. Nisreshaya. Nisreshaya means the ultimate benefit. That education is lacking. In the material world, the jnana, especially in the present age, jnana means technical knowledge. How to eat, how to sleep. Now then, somebody was telling me that they have invented eatables from petrol. So, they might be very advanced in scientific knowledge, but the ultimate aim is how to eat. That's all. Nothing more. How to eat, how to sleep, that's all. Tranquilizer pills in USA, a large selling line, that means how to sleep. This is the advancement. Scientific advancements, there is no sleeping. Without scientific knowledge, you are sleeping very nice, but with that advancement of scientific knowledge, he has lost his sleep, insomnia. So they are taking the advancement of knowledge in this way. But the Vedic scripture says, the jnanam nisyasarthaya, to achieve the highest perfection, that we are discussing in so many ways. And what is that highest perfection? Highest perfection is there, mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Nāpnubhanti mahātmāna saṁsiddhīṁ paramāṅgatā. Highest perfection, saṁsiddhīṁ paramāṁ. Param means the supreme. And saṁsiddhi means perfection. Māmupīta kauntiya dukkhālayam asāsatam nāpnubhanti mahātmāna saṁsiddhīṁ paramāṅgatā. This is highest perfection. Krishna says, all śāstra says like that. And the whole Vedic literature is meant for achieving